Can we talk about Owen? Because he's only a little lad over there, and he's a young little boy, and yet he has got that powerhouse voice. Now, you're a man with a powerhouse voice. Are you surprised that comes from that little thing over there?
Yeah, you know, he always manages to remain composed.
Yeah.
You know, he just comes out, he sings the notes just true and pure and just does his thing. And, you know, he always rises to the occasion, so, yeah, it's cool.
Yeah. Estelle, how do you think they should deal with comments from the judges? Could you deal with that? How would you react?
I think Rachel handled all her, you know, she handles it well. You know, every time I've watched, she comes back and she, you know, she does it regardless. Like, you know what? I'm going to show you something.
Yeah.
And I like how you got on the table in front of Simon. I was like,
it was just
the energy, and you feel like, you know, it felt real, you know?
Yeah.
And I think that's what's important for an artist.
Okay, I'm going to ask you all who you think might be in trouble. Can you all put your fingers in your ears? Otherwise, they're not going to give me a normal answer. Mitch?
Yes?
You can whisper. Who do you think?
Oh, wow, why am I first?
Who do you think might struggle? You know the name of
the game. I thought they were all awesome tonight.
Yes, but, and a name?
You know,
go on.
Maybe Daniel might.
Okay, Estelle?
I'm with him.
Okay.
I'm with Mitch, Daniel.
See, I always think that every week, right? But and the judges give him such a hard time.
Yeah.
But every week the people vote. I think regardless of who's in the bottom two, all right? Someone needs to go and take notes from
Lamar,
because she's amazing. Like when she goes in the bottom two, she just smacks it up. So
and she
get
goes
a pen and pad and just.
But who do you think is going to be in trouble, Lamar? You're not like getting away with it.
No, like I said.
You can't give me a name.
Like I said, every week I usually think.
Don't make me pull a break.
No. I usually think. Daniel, but, you know, I think, you know, he's got people behind him.
So. Oh, Lamar. Well, you know. Okay, well, listen, I'm going to catch up with all of you later and see if your predictions come true.
There we go.
The panel, everybody. Woo-hoo! Now, if I ask you what's the most famous thing to come out of North Canelly, then you would probably say the A48, but that has all changed now thanks to the X Factor and a Dante. Who's that, you say? Who? Have a look at this.
You are...
A Dante.
You've not made it through.
Hi, we're a Dante. And unfortunately, we only made it to the end of boot camp.
You got me begging you for mercy.
Yeah, yeah.
Why won't you release me?
Yeah, yeah.
You're not very good singers, and I can't actually take the two of you that seriously.
If you want to know what happened next, follow us.
Well, I can't believe it since we've left X Factor. It's been like Autograph City. They keep mobbing us. And we love it, don't we?
Oh, we do.
We are.
We've got a new agent who's given us lots and lots of work.
With an old smile.
Since the X Factor, since the two appearances on the show, the engagements have been pouring in for them and their diary up to the end of the year is full.
That's lovely.
No, I'm very sorry, the girls are too upmarket for that.
Speaking for Kath and myself, Adante.
Thank you.
We'd like to announce this establishment is now open.
A local radio station have contacted us.
I know.
And they've offered us. Stuff. They've offered us the Adante Hour.
Yeah, didn't I ring? Did it just slip off a tongue, didn't it?
We are the Adante Hour.
Oh, we've got Emma on line one.
Hi Emma, this is Adante. What's your request?
I'd like to request Big Spender, it's my
favourite. Okay, listeners, here we are. It's Big Spender by Adante.
A man of distinction, a real big spender. Good luck, you're so refined. Say, wouldn't you like to know what's going on?
It's just been a massive journey, and it's, I don't know, even though we didn't get right to the end, it's been such a brilliant thing for us to even be part of X Factor.
Definitely.
We're lucky girls, and
we're lucky girls. So Simon couldn't take us seriously. Well, I think everybody else has.
Cheers!
It's over.
My favourite girl band since the Satin Dolls are here right now.
Oh, I have been so excited about seeing you.
Oh my god,
you
really
look
excited.
Amazing.
Oh,
I'm loving all the glitter and the shit.
Is there in a game show horse? Do you like it?
Oh, I love it. I love it. I'm all sparkling.
Like the Dolly Dealer.
Right, are you ready to sing?
Oh,
we're ready.
Yes,
okay, here it goes. Singing live, the pride of North Canelly, it's Adante!
Oh yes, it's ladies' night. Oh, what a night.
it's ladies' night. Shh.
Come on, girls.
Gonna step out, ladies' night. Stepping out, ladies' night. Gonna step out, ladies' night. Stepping out, ladies' night. Oh yes, it's ladies' night. And the feeling's right. Oh yes, it's ladies' night. Oh what a night.
Did you enjoy that?
Oh, you love it, Ollie!
Love it!
Right, you after so the break, we'll be getting all the goss from the training team behind The X Factor. Creative director and choreographer Brian Friedman, vocal coach Evie Burnett, and stylist Faye Sawyer. You'd be crazy to miss it, Dante! Seven will become six, so who better to talk to these X Factor than the experts who work with our contestants day in, day out? Please welcome stylist Faye Sawyer, creative director and choreographer Brian Friedman, and vocal coach Evie Burnett. Hello, guys. You get it in the net, you guys, don't you? When it's good, everybody loves you, but everyone's always got something to say about it. So let's start first of all with you, Faye, and styling. Who is the easiest to style? Who do you just go, yep, done?
Well, it's hard to pick any of them out, but actually Diana, she's been really easy. I mean, yeah. Alexandra, the girl's amazing.
Yeah.
And JLS, I think it's partly because they kind of came with a bit of style. I mean, JLS came with the colours.
Yes,
so we
of
just kind of developed that. Yeah. And Diana, you know, she's your typical young girl that loves fashion.
Well, stick her in a sack and
absolutely,
she's going to look good.
Absolutely,
Diana.
Yeah.
Okay, and what about on the flip side, people that are a little bit trickier?
Well, I think we've had some problems with Rachel, but I can see that moving on. And I think it's partly, and I'm really happy it is, actually. I was really proud of her tonight. I thought she was amazing.
Yeah.
And, you know, sometimes we have to, Brian will set a kind of scene of what it's going to be like, and we have to dress a person for the song.
Because if we look back at Rachel week one,
yeah.
She was wearing this kind of trouser suit thingamajob, which I quite liked. I thought was a bit Missy Elliott. I thought
yeah,
it was
that
quite
was
cool.
The, it was Savile Row. It was a,
that was
a
the
kind
idea.
Of, yeah, it was that kind of thing. We wanted her to come out looking very strong and powerful. She was all over the stage, so you have to kind of be careful of people's modesty.
Well,
as well,
I was going to say, she was sat on a chair with legs akimbo at the
exactly
top of that.
You
nobody needs
know,
to see that
exactly
on a Saturday night.
No
X Factor
exclusives.
Okay, well, listen, Faye, thank you. If you've
thank
got
you.
Any questions about fashion or style related to the X Factor, you can go onto the website on screen right now and all your questions will be answered. It's brilliant. Now, Brian, choreography-wise, how does this work? Because some people are just born with rhythm and some people just don't have any. Who are our winners here?
Winners. Alexandra, hands down. Is
Candyman.
Yes, yeah. Candyman.
Oh, that was so cool.
I love that one. You know, she was born with rhythm. Obviously, someone in her family gave that to her.
Yeah.
But you can't really teach someone rhythm, but you can teach them to be comfortable on stage.
Right.
Ruth is another one for me who's got incredible rhythm and natural ability. When she moves, she's fluid.
Is it that kind of Spanish vibe, that sexy señorita? She's just got it pumping through her veins, isn't
she's
she?
She's trained in Latin ballroom and flamenco, so...
Can we see this, please?
I'm hoping. Give me a song if we can do that, and it'll happen.
I'd love to see that. That would be amazing. Okay, and who is struggling a little bit?
Oh, I'm going to have to say Daniel. You know, he's not a dancer. He doesn't claim to be a dancer. But he gets really nervous in that.
Does he really?
He does. He gets
so
nervous. So
you wouldn't think that as a viewer without knowing, because he seems quite confident.
Well, he always pulls it off when he gets to the stage.
Right.
It's the rehearsal process. He just gets so scared of remembering his lyrics and having to remember when to walk and where to walk. And then putting girls all around him, it makes him a little
bit
shy.
Well, he had little wandering eyes tonight, we noticed, didn't we?
Yes, he did.